Most brutal onslaughts ever devised and given to a person. And I'd like to actually see this match go well over any of the single notches that you might have actually witnessed yourself.
69, I'm pretty familiar with 69. I've known him for quite a long time. We actually trained together in his dim dark past. And I will say,
that's bullshit.
He's just come back from a very successful tour of Japan. He's wrestled all around Australia. He is one of the best that you're going to see here in this room. And Nick Eclipse definitely has his hands on
tonight. I will say that Nick Eclipse definitely does have his hands on tonight. Nick Eclipse has got a lot of tricks up his sleeve. And also, a lot of experience. I've seen him wrestle in his early days, back to some other companies. And he has been absolutely brilliant.
We'll see how brilliant he is with 69. Lock up there and go behind. Nice reversal from Nick Eclipse.
Very well done, getting into the waist lock there. 69 turning anyway. Hammerlock straight into that standing headlock. Scooping on straight back into a hammerlock again. Beautifully done there. Steps Nick Eclipse right up his back in the right. One, two. Just a high count there. Anyone on the track? Nick Eclipse straight down 69. Very quick, very efficient. Showing the experience early on in this match.
Like, you may look at 69 and you wouldn't think this guy's as fast as he is in the ring, but he's deceptively quick.
Most definitely. Very well done. Fought just right into that arm drag very quickly. Almost a Mexican standoff there, I'd say.
Good seeing you, Cliff, showing a bit of respect for the veteran in there at 69. But I reckon he might come back and bite him later in this
match. Come on! Come on, get into it again!
Sending Nick Eclipse straight into the turnbuckles. Nick Eclipse is down.
What? Obviously, he learned a few kids while he was over there. That drop kick might have been one of them.
Pummels him with that clothesline, almost taking his head off. Nick Eclipse swinging him, nothing. He's absolutely nothing. His right hand drops Nick Eclipse.
Beautiful leg drop there from 69.
And a couple ups. Almost two again. Nick Eclipse just getting out.
69 takes us to that finisher, the full release, I think he calls it. I wonder if we're going to get to see that tonight.
Hold it. Hold it. Nick Eclipse just blind walks down the place and absolutely no idea.
That's another one of those signature leg drop.
And there it is, and a couple of them up.
Two. Bit of an arrogant cover there from 69. I think maybe if you'd have hooked the leg, you might have got him there.
I would actually say so after just what he's inflicted on Nick Eclipse. But then again, you cannot discourage a man like Nick Eclipse. He's been all around Australia wrestling. Nice reversal there. Cross body into the corner. Snapping. Down goes 69 on the wing. Kick to the back.
Can you feel the tingle in his arms?
Six-year-old just kicking out of there.
Come on!
Oh, this is a bit of a turnbuckle.
Oh, there's up there a couple of stops and now third. Sets him up, whips him across. No, reversal in from 69. Nick Eclipse setting. Oh, big group there, right in the mush.
Come on, Nick.
I think there might be another one of those moves he's picked up in Japan. Stand him up for suplex.
Nope.
Snaps it, floats over it.
Cover just in the
front
there.
Come on, Brett!
The shoulder over here.
Fuck, 69!
Come on, Nick!
Come on,
I don't know, but I think the crowd are more on Nick Eclipse's side than 69 here.
I mean, it actually surprises me. I mean, I haven't seen it with 69 the rest of the world.
Same idea for
dropping
connected.
Oh, they connected, they just both went down. As I was saying, I've seen 69 wrestle many times, and I've always noticed that the crowd has actually been behind 69 100 times. But when they go up on a clothesline and they're both down, shows how long we've still been wrestling together, they can actually beat each other's moves.
Three!
So they didn't know each other very well. We've got a standing count here. One of these guys make it back to his feet to break that 10 count.
So by 69 for first up. Nick Eclipse up as well. I'll do this. Beautiful done now. Hurry to run over the city. Nick Eclipse halfway across the ring.
That's out
of you wouldn't really expect from a guy by 69, but he's just unpredictable in that
ring. He is very unpredictable, very agile, and I'd have to say this experience he's had in Japan has taught him a lot. Nicky Clips definitely saw that one coming and counted it beautifully with that. Almost devastatingly dangerous powerbomb. Drop kick there, 69 down. Nicky Clips going for a couple of ones in the bottom. Two.
Just a two count. Nicky Clips pretty slow to follow up after that.
Nicky Clips is still feeling everything in 69 in addition to him earlier, I think. Takes it off, so I come back from that much. Oh, very nice. He hits this straight to the face, right to the side of the head.
And I think Nick Lips is thinking, hey, someone answer that phone, but that's his head ringing after that kick.
Most definitely one, two. Again, Nick Lips with that shoulder up. Said, moving. 6-1, I mean, Nick Lips had full advantage of that match. Almost had the match won with a powerbomb, but the experience of 69 and just the tenacity and endurance that this man has just shown that he's once again taken the upper hand, and he's also...
wrestling from 69 gives him a chance to get a bit of a breather.
It does, but it also gives the Clips a chance to recuperate and try and get his bearings back. Look at this 69, knowing that, follows him outside the ring. Look at him, he puts him up on the guard. Oh, look at that, choking him against the guard. Right. Oh, but...
You monster!
There's so much for Nicky Clips getting his bearings back. He's just had his head scrambled on the guard.
Exactly right. I'd have to be exactly right there. That was 69 just like this.
You notice we don't have padding for here. It's like hardwood that he's just landed on.
There's not much given out at all. I'd actually have to say that there's none whatsoever. But he very slowly get up. Nicky Clips just helping 69 back into the ring there. Rolls him through.
Very slowly getting back in the ring there to follow up.
Nicky Clips looks almost practically out of it there. Just absolutely out on his feet. Both feet heading up. Roundhouse kick to the side of the head there, there goes 69.
Caught him right under the chin with that kick.
Stop for good measure. Come on, Nick. What's this, Nicky Clips? I think I know what he's doing. He's looking for the top rope.
Famous for that diving headbutt, and I think we might actually get to see it here.
Most definitely is, and he's got an absolute clearance there. He's got to go 3/4 of the way across the ring to get to it, though. Up goes Nick Eclipse. Nick Eclipse up top!
Taking a lot of time to set this up.
Very slow. What accuracy though. Diving head on 1, 2! Yeah! That's right. Your winner, Nick himself. He's taken a lot of punishment after that. He's almost rock knocked his own head, almost knocked himself out.
It's a real kamikaze headbutt. He's sort of taken his own life in his hands there, and I think he's worse off, but he's won the match. Got a bit of help coming from Nicky Clips. Let's hear it from Nicky Clips.
Look at that. That's surprise train. an Australian wrestler to actually get a win here in this industry. To put your entire body on the line and look what happens.
Exactly. He's got a win over a veteran like 69, but at what cost?
From the looks of it, it might actually be the biggest cost of all his entire career.
We've got referee Jesse Joel out there to help him out. Let's hope Nick Eclipse is alright. He's probably going to go backstage for some medical attention, but well, hopefully he's going to leave here on his own feet.
But, let's hear it for Nick Eclipse again, everybody.
Respect there from 69. Lost the match, but he's still helping him backstage there, so.